Lumberjacks is sponsored by Echo, only professional grade with 5-year warranty. Crown, protect, maintain, save. K100, for all your gas-powered equipment, make water burn. Yamaha, rev your heart.
We're standing in the banks of a world-class fishery. It's called the Campbell River, right outside the community of Campbell River, British Columbia. People travel from all over the world to get here, and not only can they fish in the river, they can fish in the Strait of Georgia as well. But we're not here for the fishing, we're here for the Logger Sports Competition, which is part of the Salmon Festival. Hi, I'm Bill Deba, with my co-host and Lumberjack Sport Analyst, Rod Cumberland. Rod, it's a great competition here out in British Columbia. This week we're covering the 0 to 140 modified chainsaw. What do you think of that one?
Well, I think that's going to be, there's lots of saws out here, and there's lots of good competitors, but we've got some transplanted Quebecers. They've moved out here, they're in Sparwood, BC. They built some the Bertrand brothers, and they're going to be hard to take down in the 0 to 140.
Another spectacular competition for the audience to watch is the choker race. People get wet in this one all the time, and when the men's choker race takes place, it's got a little bit of a twist to it as well.
Yeah, you can't skinny across that log as fast as you want to, because you have to stop and actually put a boom chain down through a hole in a boom log, so it stops them up long enough. The guy who stays the driest will win that one.
Well, we had a great start to the competition last week with crafty veterans Carl Bischoff and Dave McLeod battling it out for second place. Mitch Hewitt leading the way at 225 points. Here we are just on the edge of the Campbell River for the Campbell River Salmon Festival. All kinds of great activities to do for the whole family, including the Logger Sports Competition. We're going to be getting started with the single buck, the women's single buck. We're going to be showing you the top three heats.
Hi, I'm Danielle Koch from Grand Prairie, Alberta, and I'm a massage therapist.
Anita Jazowski, I'm from Nanaimo, BC, and I'm a safety advisor.
Well, Danielle Koch, definitely one of the best single buckers in the ladies division here in the Western Canada, but she has her hands full taking on Anita Jazowski here on the right.
Both women have a good start in this 18 inches rounder white pine. Oh, a little bit of a hang up there for Anita at the beginning. It looks like Danielle's well on her way ahead of Anita at this point.
And Danielle's making really nice, full, long, smooth strokes, and she's actually doing a super job here. If she can get it off when she gets in the small one, she's going to have a great time.
Anita really struggling towards the end here. Looks like Danielle Koch is going to win the first heat of the women's single buck with a time of 23.18.
So, Danielle, how'd you like that single buck cut?
Not too bad. My saw was a little bit jammy near the bottom. I'm not sure what I was doing or what was going on, but for the most part, it was good. I kept a good pace. And
Do you think that time will hold?
I would think so. I finished quite a bit before the lady I was going against, Anita, and she's usually right behind me in sawing, so I should place pretty well in this one.
Congratulations. Good job.
Thank you.
Janice Burns, Slocan, BC, lifestyle entrepreneur.
Sarah Mooney from Euclid, BC, and I'm a paramedic.
Well, Sarah Mooney's been a strong women's single buck sawyer in British Columbia for many years. Actually, her arch rival, Anita Jazowski, we just saw her in the first heat. Anita comes in with a 27.15. Danielle Koch with 23.18. We got Janice Burns in this heat. Should be a great battle.
Janice Burns is a tall girl. She's got long arms. Actually, you'd think she's really well built for the single buck, but you see her struggling out of the gate here. She must have a really aggressive saw because it's a little bit catchy.
And there's the veteran experience of Sarah Mooney just going about her business there with her father, Matt Mooney, coaching her on. Nice, smooth, long strokes. Not overly fast for Sarah, but really consistent.
Janice is really struggling here on the left-hand side. You see her hanging rakers left and right. If I was to guess, I'd say it's a two-peg and raker as Sarah Mooney knocks it off here in a 24.9.
Sarah, you've always been a strong single bucker there. You know, just tell me a little bit about that. There were no hiccups or anything?
No, it seemed to be a good cut. The saw was running a bit heavy, but it was cutting good.
Yep. And how much coaching does your father give you during that cut?
He could have been yelling, "I didn't hear a thing." I don't know. I block it out.
Casey Leffler, Burnaby, BC, and I'm a personal trainer.
I'm Caitlin Stewart. I'm from Chetwynd, British Columbia, and I'm a grade one teacher.
Danielle Koch still has a time to beat with 23.18 set in the first heat here, the women's single buck. This next heat, Caitlin Stewart, great all-round lumberjack sport athlete, taking on relative newcomer in the sport, Casey Leffler.
And, of course, both of them you can see coached on by pretty seasoned veterans here in the sport as well. Carl Bischoff giving Casey all kinds of pointers in the single buck.
Caitlin Stewart is a good sawyer. It looks like the log might be a little bit high for her. She struggled at the beginning, but right now she's on her way and she's got good, clean strokes. Casey on the right-hand side struggling a little bit.
Both these ladies obviously not as tall in stature as some of the other girls that are doing the single buck, and that's typically to your disadvantage in single butt. But look at Caitlin Stewart. She is pouring it on here right now.
Just picking up the pace with a roar of the crowd. Casey on the right-hand side struggling towards the end. Caitlin Stewart's going to win this heat. She's not going to take down Danielle, but she clocks in with a time of 32.10.
So, Caitlin, that looked like a really good cut. What'd you think of it?
Oh, I thought it was okay. There was times that it was good, and then there was definitely some hang-ups where I went a bit wild.
You seemed to really pick up your pace at the end.
Yeah, I realized that I was halfway through and I had some more gas in the tank, so I tried to lay it on a bit more.
Well, this is a sport where experience makes a world of difference. Danielle Koch, the veteran competitor from Alberta, taking it with a 23.18. It's a great day here at the Campbell River Salmon Festival. Just before the show got started, I had a chance to talk to one of the great sponsors, Kevin Boothroyd of Pacific Coastal Airlines.
Well, Bill, our roots are really in the forest industry. We were begun nearly 40 years ago by a truck logger in Bella Coola, Daryl Smith. And here we are today, nearly 40 years later. We're now the sixth largest airline operating out of YVR and the third largest airline in takeoffs and landings. We do about 320,000 outbound seats in the province of British Columbia, and one of them is beautiful Campbell River, and we're proud to be a supporter of this event. As a small domestic airline, you have to work harder than the big guys, and one of the ways we have to do that is really truly getting down and being part of the community. I like to say to people that we're a put up or shut up airline. We actually show up with cash, with people at every event in every community in British Columbia, from Aboriginal events to community events to city events. This year alone, we've been at the Sam Steele Days Parade, we've been at the Trail Silver City Days Parade, we're in the Williams Lake Stampede Parade, and we really love being part of those communities and really, really proud to be BC's airline.
Well, this is one of my favorite lumberjack sport events. It's called the Choker Race, and here in Campbell River, they do it right. A variety of different disciplines involved here. This first heat of three, we have Eric Hoberg taking on Alan Carson.
You see both competitors wearing long pants, and of course you want to stay up on top of the boom logs here and stay dry so you can actually maneuver and run well through the rest of the course.
Now, one of the keys to getting across the log here on the pond is watching ahead. You don't want to watch your feet. It's really getting a feel for it. You look ahead and you hopefully make it across the pond, and both these guys make it as they go over the first bunk log with their 80-pound choker cables.
Yeah, pretty tough and demanding event, of course, carrying that long cable. You've got to flip that bell underneath. Both guys do it very well. They get their They're hooked and they're back off across the pond.
Looks like Alan Carson slightly ahead as he picks up his boom chain. Eric Hoberg playing catch up right now. Alan takes a little bit of time to switch over hands. Both guys are making it to the center. Hoberg goes in. Alan Carson, he goes into the drink as well.
The interesting thing is they have to be on top of the log in order to set the boom chain. So both guys have to get back on it here. One set and he's back off across. He's going to actually try to swim in here and make it to the end of the finish line.
Yeah, I guess Carson figures he's going to be quicker by walking out. And so is Hoberg. Alan Carson wins the first heat. So a bit of a mishap there. First of all, you're alive and well.
Yep, doing good.
Just tell me how the octaves have gone up in your throat a little bit.
Well, it's not as bad as you think. The pool is not quite as deep, luckily, because if it was the way, I'd be singing a soprano for sure.
Anyway, Lumberjack Sports is all about finishing. You did a good job finishing, right?
Yeah, you bet. You never give up.
Hi, I'm Dave McLeod. I'm a misplaced Cape Bretoner living in Campbell River, British Columbia. I'm a professional tree faller.
This is Dennis Yarjou. I live in Campbell River and work for BC Hydro.
No, this will be a great battle. Dennis taking on Dave, both guys from Campbell River, both guys helping out with the logger sports competition a lot over the years as they head over the Burling Pond.
Dave McLeod, of course, as he said, from Cape Breton. When he came out here, he had to learn all these events, the boom run, the pole climb, but boys, he's done a great job here picking up these disciplines.
And it looks like a mirror image of each other as they both get to the bunk lock at the exact same time, set their choker cables, and away they go around the standing block stands.
Well, let's look at this. Dave McLeod, he's no slouch in this event at all. He loves this one here. Dennis Yarjou, the long legs will give him a little bit of an advantage. He's the first guy to cross the pond, but he's in the drink.
And Dave McLeod, he's standing. No, Dave McLeod straddles the log and falls down right in his crotch. He does a crotch drop, and Dave McLeod is putting his chain in. Dave, looks like Dennis is going to walk in. Dave McLeod up on the boom, and he crosses it and wins the heat. Great race for you, buddy, Dave McLeod from Camel River. Dead heat to the very, very end, and you chose to walk it off.
I went through the water. Big mistake. Should have gone up on the log.
Yeah, and he chose to go up on the log. He beat you, but just tell me about racing Dave McLeod. A lot of fun?
It's always fun with Dave. Great competitor. Me and him have been going at this for so long that maybe his youth has taken over on me.
Thanks a lot.
Okay, thank you.
Jody Evans, Vancouver, BC. I put on lumberjack shows for a living. Nick Russell, Port McNeil, British Columbia, professional forester.
Well, it's Jody Evans that puts on the Lumberjack shows atop a Grouse Mountain in Vancouver, British Columbia. First time we've seen him here on Lumberjack's TV series, taking on Nick Russell in the choker race.
Oh, and Evans is in the drink right off the bat. Nick Russell, of course, he's from New Brunswick. He's a second-generation Lumberjack competitor, doing a great job here in the boom run. He's got his choker set, and he's ready to head back across the pond, doing a great run here.
Nick Russell ahead of Jody at this point as Jody's trying to play catch-up. Nick Russell across the final bunk log, picking up his boom chain.
And actually, he's taking his time here, getting his feet set. Sometimes that's a disadvantage because you don't have the pace set up, and he's in. He's got to get back on the log before he can set the boom chain. Both guys in right now, so it's going to be a race to see who can get back on the log and finish this.
Once again, you can't stand on the bottom of the pond and put your chain in. You've got to be on the log somehow. Jody Evans got his chain in. He makes his way to the end, and Jody Evans wins this last heat of the choker race over Nick Russell. Great come from behind victory there. You were in a bit of a race. You started off ahead and then behind. Just tell me about it.
I fell in on the way over and got a face full of water. And it had a good set. And then on the way back, I thought I could get that chain in, but as soon as that log turns, you're in the water. So.
Well, he got a little bit wet, but Jody Evans still pulls out a fourth place finish here in the men's choker race. But it's Dave McLeod taking home the gold with a 37.25.
We're back here at the Campbell River Salmon Festival and the Logger Sports Competition. There's all kinds of family activities to do. It's an event that happens every year in the month of August. One of the exhibitors this year is Echo Chainsaw Carver, Ryan Cook. I'm with Ryan Cook, and Ryan, just tell me a little bit about how you got started with Echo Chainsaw Carver, and how long you've been doing it, and a brief history of yourself.
Well, I've been carving for 3 years. I got started on the TV show Saw Dogs. I was hired as an actor and was the apprentice, so I was the bumbling fool, and you know, reality's reality. And we got, I basically kept going after that. The show was over, life went back. I was like, well, marketing, desk job, or do I want to carve? And I kept doing it for the next 3 years, turned pro last year here in Campbell River. I won the semi-professional competition, and then this year I got second place in the pros, and Echo and I started working together. I'm the first Canadian ever to be sponsored by Echo. It's pretty awesome.
My name is Simon Bertrand. I'm from Sparwood, BC. I worked as a welder and machinist at Rico Steel.
Hi, I'm Troy Lambert. I'm from Ballester, BC. I'm the owner and operator of In-N-Out Recycling.
Well, I like Troy Lambert. He's always giving 100% here in the BC circuit. A little bit unorthodox in his style. And here he is in the hot saw taking on Simon Bertrand.
He's going to have to give it 100% here because Simon Bertrand not only builds these things, he runs them very well. Biggest thing in BC, you only have 2 inches of wood to get these cuts off. Simon Bertrand puts a good one down. He's got a cut off. Two of them here in 8.2 seconds.
Well, in an earlier heat, we did not see. McLeod had an 8.64. Simon takes him down by a half a second here, but he's pretty much flawless here, and it looks like he really knows what he's doing.
A little bit of a stall getting that second cut going, but again, the saw's cutting really well as we get into our next heat.
We got Jody Evans taking on Caitlin Stewart. Once again, both competitors running modified 140cc saws with extension pipes.
And again, Caitlin Stewart, no slouch at all. She's not scared to run these saws one bit, even though they're almost the size of her.
Good start for Jody Evans. He's into the wood. Caitlin Stewart keeping up right with him there. Jody Evans on his upcut, and Jody Evans throws a chain here. Looks like Caitlin Stewart's going to make her second cut. And she comes in with a 12.10, but what happens with Jody Evans here on his upcut, maybe being a little bit too aggressive.
Too aggressive. Again, these chains are filed really sharp, and he's putting a lot of weight on it, of course, and all of a sudden the chain breaks. He's sitting here, hopes no more problems happen with his saw.
Well, he's going to take a DQ for that. Caitlin Stewart comes in with a 12.01. This is our last heat of the modified chainsaw. Once again, we have a man-woman heat here. Daniel Koch from Alberta taking on local favorite Dennis Yarjow.
Dennis Yarjow's run this same old saw. He must be almost as old as he is.
Well, he's got his shaggy DA haircut with his Ben Hogan golf hat. If this event were about style alone, he'd win hands down over Danielle.
Well, if you look at the saws here, Danielle's got the newer, faster saw, but Dennis Yarjow, he's no stranger at all, no slouch in the modified saw event. Look at that, he's got his one cookie on the ground already.
Well, they're trying to take down the time of 7.67. They're not going to be doing that. It's a dead heat between the two of them, and Dennis Yarjow just edges out Danielle Koch in this heat. What a great job for an old-timer with an old-time saw beating Danielle. Nice and well. This is what experience does as well. You just relax, you let your saw do the cutting, and you just make sure you keep the saw in the wood.
Well, the man with the home field advantage, Dave McLeod, sneaking in again. Fourth place here in the modified saw. Simon Bertrand takes third. And a heat a little bit early in the day, Carl Bischoff takes first place with a 7.67.
Welcome back to Lumberjack TV series. We're here in Campbell River, British Columbia for the Logger Sports Competition, part of a great annual event held every August, and they call it the Salmon Festival. We are headed into the last event of this episode, and they call it the Butcher Block.
I know, Bill, your favorite event is to watch a choker race, but mine by far is the Butcher Block. We've got two guys here, a team of two. One guy chops halfway through the underhand. His partner jumps on then and finishes that, and then they do the same thing in a standing block.
Well, certainly we have a team favorite here. We got Jesse and Mitch, both guys originally from Down Under. One guy from Australia, one guy from New Zealand, where, I mean, Axemen are fantastic, but they're taking on a couple of Canadians. Never challenge the heart and soul of a Canadian competitor.
And again, Nick Russell has really picked up his pace in his underhand chopping. Dave McLeod's been doing it for a long time. He's no slouch at all either, but it looks like sometimes it comes down to the wood, and it looks like the Aussies here are picking some pretty hard wood.
Well, looks like Mitch Hewitt and Nick Russell are first in the log here right now. Both guys still working on the first side. Nick Russell doing a great job. A little bit tight in the front side there, but Dave McLeod just behind Jesse Whitehead.
Jesse Whitehead, the first one on, and he's got a good pace, wailing in this block. Dave McLeod's got a feverish pace here.
Dave McLeod has always got that very fast pace, a little bit shorter swing there. Jesse Whitehead, very controlled, hitting it hard, and hitting it accurate.
Dude, that's exactly what you need in the underhand chop. You see here the Aussies and New Zealand team are way out in front. Mitch Hewitt, this is his signature event, the standing block, doing a great job. They've got a big lead here on the guys from the east.
Well, they're actually guys from the west now. They're originally from the east, but Nick Russell's doing a great job of trying to keep up with Mitch Hewitt. I don't think he's going to catch him at this point, so unless there's a bit of a train wreck with Jesse and Mitch, they're probably going to take this heat. But Nick Russell, look at him go.
And actually, look at the difference in the wood here, Bill. Nick Russell doing a great job with it, but his wood is chipping out a whole lot better than Mitch Hewitt's.
Well, Nick Russell's not quite, he's a little bit sloppy in his lines as well. You can see a variety of different lines. You look at Mitch Hewitt and Jesse Whitehead's lines, they're straight and they're dead on.
But boys, the block of wood here is a lot harder. Dave McLeod wailing away at this soft pumpkin white pine. He actually may catch Jesse.
Jesse Whitehead's going to take a couple more upstrokes. Dave McLeod making a great effort to try and catch up. A couple more up-hits for him. He's going to try and drive things off. Jesse's trying to drive things off. He's got to reach for his firewood right now. And Jesse Whitehead and Mitch Hewitt set the time to beat with a 138.52.
And a really respectable finish here by Dave McLeod and Nick Russell. So watching that chop, the wood looked a little bit firm, a little bit dry. How'd your axes do in the wood?
Yeah, it was dry wood, and I struggled. My axe wasn't cutting, and it was tough.
So when that happens, Jesse, did anything you change when all of a sudden you notice your axe isn't cutting the wood as good as you thought?
Just try and hit it a bit harder, big long swings.
Well, actually, if truth be told, we know that Mitch Hewitt's best axes are still stuck in Toronto. He had them shipped out there for a big show in the East just a while ago, and of course, he's down to his third or fourth best axe in his box now because his good axes still haven't made it back across the country.
Well, this last heat of the Butcher Block, these two pair of competitors are going to have a big challenge, taking down the time of 138.52, set by Mitch and Jesse in the last heat. We got Bischoff and Bertrand, the killer bees, taking off Pouchnik and Yarjow.
And again, you can tell it's a really hot day. This is in the middle of the day. The guys' shirts are filled with sweat from all that they've done, and now they're going to chop big 13, 14-inch blocks here, two in a row.
Well, the first guys in the underhand chopper, Dennis Yarjow and Carl Bischoff. You can see Shaggy D.A. there. He's hitting really fast, but I'm not sure if his axe is really driving into the wood. Carl Bischoff in the underhand chop here, well, no, there's no secret. His younger years are behind him, and he just hasn't have the power anymore.
These blocks both seem pretty dry to me. The axes aren't sinking very well in them, so the guys are slowing down, trying to make all the strokes count, hit accurately, and looks like Dennis Yarjo's bailing out, and Dennis is taking over.
Derek Pouchnik taking over from Dennis Yarjo right now. Simone Bertrand taking off from Carl Bischoff. Guys picking up the pace right at the beginning here, and Simone Bertrand, he's hitting his lines pretty good, chipping out his first couple of chips.
Again, pace is a lot slower, though. Derek has a pretty good pace here, but Simone Bertrand is actually taking one swing to every two that Derek is making.
Boy, if you look at Simone's cut here right now, you can see exactly what we're talking about. We're talking about stair-stepping. He's got a variety of different lines, wasting a lot of energy and effort on his swings as Carl Bischoff takes over in the standing block almost at the exact same time as Shaggy D.A., Dennis Yarjow.
Looks like Dennis Yarjow's wood's moving a whole lot nicer than Carl's. Carl, it's a bit of a hanger there. Gets out of the way because it is dangerous if you swing at that piece of wood that's hanging out of there, but Dennis Yarjow here really sinking his axe. Carl Bischoff seems to be running out of gas, and truth be known, his axes are in the same box as Mitch Hewitt's out in Toronto.
Well, Shaggy D.A. is really picking up the pace here. He's giving it everything he can to get through this first part of the standing block chop. He's about to put some drivers in for Derek Pouchnik, and Derek's about to take over in the backside. Carl's really struggling.
They're pulling away right now, the team of Yarjow and Pouchnik are pulling away as Carl Bischoff here just trying to hang on, get some drivers in so he can actually tag team and give this thing over to Simon Bertrand.
Well, he may not have the axe that he wants, and his wood is just not moving. I don't think they're going to catch Derek and Dennis at this point. Derek's taking out some good wood here, and his wood is really chipping.
Yeah, I really have to feel for Carl Bischoff as white wood, dry pine as he hands off to Simon Bertrand. You see Derek Pouchin's block here, the orange in it shows there's a lot of moisture in it as he drives things off here with a time of 2 minutes and 10 seconds in the butcher block. Okay, so how much of an advantage is it to watch teams go ahead of you in a race like a butcher block?
None. We know those guys are really, really good choppers, so we want to catch them, but I said to watch that speed to what they cut doesn't help us at all.
You have to chop within yourself and use your own abilities and work with what you got.
Well, in the heat of the August afternoon here in Campbell River, British Columbia, Whitehead and Hewitt just edge out McLeod and Russell by 8 seconds.
And the Crown Pivotal Point Spotlight focuses squarely on the shoulders of the man from Myra River, Dave McLeod, who pulls out a great win in the choker race and putting him back in the running for the overall.
And that's exactly where we respect Dave McLeod every year at the Campbell River Salmon Festival on top of the leaderboard. Him and Mitch Hewitt are battling it out with Bischoff, Whitehead, and Bertrand still in the race, but it's going to be a tough time catching them.
And the gas guzzler lumberjack of the day is actually a lumberjill, our national champion, Danielle Koch from Alberta. She takes a first place finish in the single buck, and she's in the running for the overall of the ladies.
Is sponsored by Echo, only professional grade with 5-year warranty. Crown, protect, maintain, save. Quickdam, the new alternative to heavy sandbags. Yamaha, rev your heart.
Here in Campbell River, the choker race is a little bit more technical than other places. They've got to run the course, set this choker through the bell, around the log. On the way back, they have to pick up this boom chain, which weighs about 20 pounds, make their way across a boom log, stop halfway across, and feed that boom chain down through the boom log. I'm going to show you just how easy it is to do this event. See how easy that is?